And now for our news in business, the government through Microfinance Chigezi Zonal Branch has donated 168 bags of potato seedlings and 9 bags of climbing bean seedlings worth 47 million shillings, and this was donated to 25 women groups in Kabale district. Now the group is run under the Ndorwa West Women Development Association. We have the report. The beneficiaries, led by the coordinator of Ndorwa West Women Development Association, Patience Tusime, commended the government for the support. She advised other women to ensure that the seedlings are not misused so they can become model farmers. Tusime, however, noted that some families have not been able to develop because women are denied a chance to join development groups.
The families there, their background may be, you find some women, they have some problems with their husbands, or they have some violences in home for such a groups, joining such a groups without maybe consent from their husbands. But I think we are going to sensitize them, most especially those who are not in these groups.
Speaking during the handover ceremony at Ndiabyumba Farmers Resource Center, the Chigezi Zonal Regional Manager of Microfinance Support Center, Boaz Tuhumwire, said they selected the association following the request from the area legislator, who is also the State Minister for Finance, David Bahati, to support them.
When they get this quality seed and they're able to have better yields and production, they will be able to accumulate money which they will be able to save in their groups. Then in the long run, these very people can be able to access credit funds and pay them very well. This is in the form of giving them a seed, and we are pirating. It is not that these people, they are going to pay back. No, it is a pirating. It's a pilot study. We want to see how do we build the structure, the financial structure of these self-help groups.
He said seedlings will benefit 594 members. Groups that requested potato seedlings will get 14 bags, while those that requested climbing beans will get 120 kilograms per group.
When they get this quality seed and they're able to have better yields and production, they will be able to accumulate money which they will be able to save in their groups. Then in the long run, these very people can be able to access credit funds and pay them very well. This is in the form of giving them a seed, and we are pirating. It is not that these people, they are going to pay back, no.
Minister Bahati, through his political assistant Wilbur Kanyesije, said the main goal of the government is to move a big percentage of families into commercial farming. Uganda's biggest challenge is that most families engage in subsistence farming. According to Charles Biaruhanga, potato farmers in Chigezi still struggle with challenges of land fragmentation, which at times compromises their production potential.
Itaka erituru kuyinga mutwa iho muskuri na usahere abo kugira ngo itaka ryetu rya kabariri naganagiro kuno nico niyo fragmente de land erituru mwene ebizibe bitutunga nibyo kugira ngo no bote ine itaka likwatire hamwe uvuge ko kuba oyindo kwererere umwe akuriyetere kizibu nkayata mwe mu ndiziri kuba zitari koriki.
Irish potato in Uganda is a good food security crop and is grown in the highland areas of southwestern Uganda in two districts of Kabale and Kisoro. In the two districts, Irish potato is both a staple food and a main source of income. The two districts produce over 60% of the national crop. This story was done by Job Namanya for the news in